Hey guys, how's everyone doing? I'm AnimeIntensity and welcome back to my channel. Today we're having another Manga First Take where I talk about cool new manga series and give you like my first impressions of them. This manga is definitely still ongoing, so it's not a full-length series review, but just my first thoughts on what I've read so far. So far we have two volumes of this manga and I waited until volume two. I was going to review it after volume one, but I was like, no, I need to know what happens next and review them both. So that's why I waited until volume two was released. I'm so excited to be talking about this manga today, mainly because I am such a big fan of horror and I'm also a huge fan of like horror comedies. So I love that blend of genres and some of my favorite movies happen to be horror comedies. So I'm really excited to talk about this because now I am so into the series. I can't wait until volume three. And if you haven't heard of the series already, you definitely should read it if you are into this stuff. So today we are going to be talking about the very lovely Mieruko-chan. So yeah, this is Mieruko-chan volume one and Mieruko-chan volume two. This manga is being released by Yen Press, and from what I've seen, like, a lot of you seem to know about this. I didn't know anything about this before I read it. I was like, I don't know what this, she has a cell phone in her hand. It must be some kind of, you know, death game that you play on your cell phone. That's what it's about, right? And I was totally wrong. I couldn't be further away from the truth because, you know, I go into these things completely blind. I don't read synopsis or anything. Like, I don't read anything. I'm just like, okay, look at the cover. I'm like, okay, it looks like it's gonna be scary, maybe a psychological thing. She's staring at her cell phone. Not at all. So I went into this completely blindly and wow, now I know the hype. I understand the hype because I've heard such amazing things about it and I'm like, geez, I think I love it too now. So I'm really excited to be talking about Mieruko-chan today. It is a horror comedy rated for older teen, just a heads up for any of those, any of you who are concerned about the age. Before I talk about anything else regarding this manga, I'm just gonna get closer so you guys can see the cover of these first two volumes because I don't want to forget. I feel like if I don't do it now, it's never going to happen. So this is volume one of Mieruko-chan. This came out maybe like a month or two ago. And this is volume two, which just came out this month in February. Mieruko-chan is about a girl named Miko, and Miko can actually see ghosts. She can see spirits. They're not the fun, cute, you know, playful spirits. They're like, oh, how nice. No, these are the things that are like created out of nightmare fuel. What scares me are like big, hollow-eyed creatures, shadowy blob-like things. Like, it just creeps me out. And Mieruko-chan is filled with them almost on every page or so. So if you are easily creeped out by things like that too, this manga will like, ugh, like it just leaves you with like an unsettling feeling because you know that on every page or so, something's gonna pop out at you. In fact, if they made this into an anime, this is a perfect jump scare anime. It should just be called JUMPSCARES. The anime. It really, I feel like that's how frequent we see these spirits. And these aren't like the friendly, your friendly ghosts. It's not Casper, I tell you that much. And so these spirits, they haven't exactly done anything bad so far from what I've seen to Miko, but she's continuously haunted by these nasty looking ghost spirit things. And she kind of pretends that she can't see them, but she can. She can definitely see them, but she kind of like ignores them or like denies it. She's like, you know, like, okay, if I don't look this way, they'll just disappear. Just like the movies. They'll go away. They won't, you know? So she tries to just like, I feel like she's in denial. And instead of like facing them head on, she's like, okay, okay, you know, like, this is totally fine. but she's really not fine. So she has a friend at school. Her friend does not see these ghosts at all, although the ghosts are always around this girl. So it's kind of funny because Miko sees all these spirits around her and she's like, how do you not see that? Like, they're all around you. They're touching you. They're, you know, like, come on. And they just try to live like their everyday lives while being surrounded by these spirits. Well, Miko knows about it. Her friend doesn't know that these spirits are around them. But it's funny to see the interactions between them both and how one girl, or aka Miko, is always scared of something. And her friend is like, do you have anemia? Should we go to the infirmary? Are you okay? Like, what's going on? So you see these two people who are living in a world where there are these ugly, nasty ghost creatures, and one can see them, one cannot. So it's a fun story that definitely has comedy to it, and even a little bit of fan service at times, I feel. But Mieruko-chan still had those moments, especially when I opened the first page. I did not expect that the first, not even the first page, this is the inside cover. I was like, who wants to see this? And when I first saw that, the line says, can you see me? And in the first couple of pages, the same ghost thing is saying, can you see me? Can you see me? And I'm just like, yes, I can see you. Can you go away now? A lot of these creatures, these ghosts, don't look nice. There's one that reminds me of that movie Teeth. And honestly, I did not need to see that today. I'm good. There's also like one ghost that looked kind of cute at first that stole her 500 yen coin, and it turned out not being cute at all. So looks can be a little deceiving, I guess, too. But there are a lot of ghosts or spirits here that look very creepy. And if you are very like startled by disturbing images, this maybe isn't a title for you. It does make me uncomfortable, but after a certain point, I was just expecting it because it's so frequent in this manga. Like, I'm talking about, like, seeing one of these ghost-like things, like, every page or so. So, I don't know. I wouldn't say it was getting repetitive, but I expected it. I was like, watch me turn the page. I was like, oh, it is there. You know, like, come on. Like, I knew it was coming, but I was still scared. So that's how I felt when reading this manga. They're so frequent. You'll see a lot of these things. And also at the end of volume one, you'll get like a little, I don't want to say a twist, but kind of like a surprise, because I didn't expect that. And I was like, hold on, did I just read that? So there was a little surprise at the end of volume one. Volume two actually starts talking about, this one is funny because we get introduced to another character. And this character is the granddaughter of this lady who was going to sell them some prayer beads. So Miko was like, I need some prayer beads. This is obviously not working. They're not going away. So they go to buy these prayer beads that just keep breaking and breaking and breaking, unfortunately. And eventually they meet the granddaughter of the person who sold them the beads. And this girl is like, you totally see them. Why don't you do something? Why don't, you know, like, why don't you admit it? Why, you know, like, look at me. I'm trying to face them head on and you're just not trying to do anything. And so we have different characters. You know, we have a girl, Miko, who can see everything. Her friend, who, like, I'm still bad with names, I'm sorry. Her friend, who can't see them but has a powerful aura and attracts everything. And then we also have this girl who was the granddaughter of the woman that they bought the prayer beads from, and she's also another type of personality, and she's just like ready to fight. She's like, okay, I'm gonna be the next. I'm gonna be just like grandma. I see all these spirits, or not, I'm gonna, you know. So you have three completely different personalities, and I can't wait to see volume three. Like, what is going to happen in this manga? I have no idea. I almost feel very bad for Miko, because if I lived her life, I don't know what would happen. It's a pretty scary situation if you were actually put into Miko's shoes, because that's a, imagine every 5 seconds seeing something in the mirror right next to you. Open your locker, there's a head inside. Like, come on, like, really? So there are a lot of creepy things to find in this manga, but they do it in such a way that it's not too scary, I guess you could say. The images are kind of unsettling and disturbing, but it's not too scary, like, oh my god, I can't read anything for the rest of my life because this traumatized me. Like, it's not like that kind of horror. It's funny. At times, you will like the characters. They're all different. And you will like the delivery of everything. So it's just like boom, 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 boom. Like, it just constantly, constantly moves on. You see different things every single page. And I really enjoyed it for what it was. The art is also a big plus for me. These spirits, they are very well illustrated. That's all I'll say. overall an enjoyable read, and I really recommend this. Thank you guys so much for watching this video. If you've read this manga already, feel free to comment below and tell me your thoughts on Mieruko-chan. I had a lot of fun talking about it today with you all, and if you liked this video, feel free to subscribe to this channel. Please subscribe to this channel and share my content if you liked this video, okay? So feel free to like, share, comment, or subscribe if you like this video, and I will see you guys next time. Bye!